This is the Elizabeth Street Garden in Little Italy, New York, the heart of one of the world's great neighborhoods.
When I think of this garden, I think of a warmth, a sense of home. There's peace here. I think of that line by Yeats where he talks about going to the island of Innisfree where peace comes dropping slow. And you can feel peace here. New York can be a very isolating and lonely place. But when you have a garden as beautiful as this, it entices people into it. And we're talking about a place where the community can come together.
For me, the park is that it's the center of our neighborhood.
Bring nature and culture and artistry together. It's just a beautiful space.
A center of our community.
A place where neighbors can come together to meet each other the old-fashioned way.
People say to you in the street, oh, I know you from the garden. And that's a wonderful sense of belonging.
This is a garden people really need more than you would think. Once you are in, you feel like a human being again in a big city.
You have foliage and you have grass and you don't feel like you're in the city for a few moments of the day, and that's therapeutic.
It's got some magical vibes to it. It does.
This garden, which is not terribly big, is the only place in this area where parents can bring their children.
Then you can see lots of bugs and butterflies.
So children can come here and they're introduced in a small way, but in a very important way, to the world of nature.
That's the only place we see grass and trees, and the only garden in our neighborhood.
Well, I like it because of the plants.
And if you have a child in here and his father teaches him how to dig with it, as I've seen fathers and mothers do, teach them how to grow something in that little vegetable garden and watch them watch that thing grow. That's an amazing gift to give to give somebody who will then give it to his kids.
I think it's a place where children can actually connect with the environment.
It's very important to root to the earth, to water, the sun, the light, for the children. If not, they're really deprived in a great way.
I love the garden.
Our dog Rufus loves the park. He loves to sniff around and, you know, meet people and other dogs, and he doesn't get to take a break off the sidewalk that often, so we like to come here.
It's a nice environment to take your pet.
The garden was built by Alan Reaver in 1991. The garden is made open to the public through the volunteer efforts of local residents.
So if you live a life in a cubicle in an office and you never see green or you never see dirt or you never see the sky, you're really ripped out of your full matrix. You're not playing with a full deck.
How we look after our old people, how we look after the vulnerable, how we look after our children. These are the marks of what it means to be a compassionate society. This garden could serve as a template for other places in New York.
Elizabeth Street Garden is now under threat of development and thus destruction. All this could go, replaced by more concrete, more buildings.
We don't have many of these places in New York. Please, please think about not the mechanics or the facilities, but to think about the spiritual life of the community. Not just for us who live here now, but for our grandchildren and great-grandchildren who will turn around one day and say, thank you for preserving this. Thank you for keeping this for us, because it's a gift forever.
I don't know what I'd do if it wasn't here anymore, you know?
This is something people need, I think, and I need it as well.
People treasure the parks now. It really would be against the current of the times and of the city.
There are absolutely no other areas other than the Elizabeth Street Garden in Little Italy and Soho where people can go and walk on green grass.
So to see green, to see the glint of the sun through a green leaf, that's not a luxury. That's an amenity that you can't be fully human without.
I would feel enormously sad if I walked past here and I said to friends or grandkids or children, there used to be a beautiful garden in there and people used to congregate there, and it was somewhere that people loved to be. And there's a building there now. But you can't imagine how beautiful it was.
You would never get it back again. It would be lost forever, and it would be a great travesty to lose it. It's just a wonderful space.
We want to keep this.
Think of your own children. Think of your grandchildren. Think of your great-grandchildren. We are stewards of these places. These places are given to us. The grasses, the trees, the leaves, the flowering. These things are not here by accident. They are gifts that we are given. In terms of what it gives to the internal life, the internal life of a community, it is invaluable.